So in this series which I have been talking about dividends, let me give you some more features about the dividends. So dividend is something which we have seen as a compensation to the equity shareholder or the preference shareholder for being invested in a company. Company earns well, company pays tax, company has a surplus, so company pays you dividend. The best thing about the dividend is it's proof that the company has got cash. Company can declare a very high earning, but you are not sure about it till you receive your dividend. Now, when dividend is paid, the company is saying, "We earned this money, here is the cash, and here is what we are rewarding you with." Obviously, the market looks at companies which pay dividend with far greater respect than companies which do not pay dividend. Having said that, it is perfectly possible for, say, an HDFC bank today, after such a long existence, to say, "I will be paying lesser dividend because I'm going to use that money for growth." Perfectly all right, because now we trust the company. But if this company had said in 1997 or 98 that we will not be paying any dividends at all because we are going to use the money for growth, the market may have looked at it very differently than how it is looking at than how it is being looked at today, right? So in general, a company can choose when to pay a dividend, whether to increase a dividend, whether to cut out a dividend, whether to decrease, or have a policy that we will increase it by at least 5% every year, because that is the projected rate of inflation as far as RBI is concerned. So we will increase it by 5% every year, or you can say we will increase it by 10% every year, because people have to be compensated for getting into a riskier asset class. So therefore, I will be increasing it by 10%. But remember, they can cut it out when they feel that they don't have the cash or they want to conserve the cash. There is no fixed commitment. It's not like interest that you will definitely get this much. So it is something at the discretion of the board of directors. Having said that, if the company declares something called an interim dividend, that is paid out immediately. So if the board declares a 10% interim dividend, you will get 10% of the face value. Many people think that if you buy say an HDFC bank share at 2,000 rupees in the market and get a 10% dividend, no, you will not get 200 rupees. You will look at the face value. Maybe the face value is 5 rupees, so 10% of that is 50 paise. That is the amount of dividend you will get per share. So people do make this mistake. People have asked me, "Why am I not getting 10% of the market price?" No, it is 10% of the face value of the share. So this is something important to know. The best thing about dividends are it is non-refundable. Where if your share price goes up and you think you're going to, Monday morning I'm going to sell, Saturday, Sunday something happens and Monday morning is not worth selling because the price has dropped a lot. You were expecting an X amount of money, you're not going to get that. Now, are you willing to wait for some more time? That is your reading of the market, or you say, "No, no, I need the money now, so whatever be the price, you sell it," right? So two things, but whatever you have as dividend is realized and it is in your pocket. It is easily the best way how you can be compensated without you losing control of the shares that you have. The other way to look at it is somebody like a Berkshire Hathaway pays no dividend at all. So you say, "Okay, I have got 10,000 shares or I got 5,000 shares. I need so much money, so I'll sell off 2 shares or 5 shares or 10 shares," depending on how much money you need and what is the price, market price as on that date, right? So that is many companies pay dividends on a quarterly basis. Earlier, they used to be physically sent by way of check, etc., which was very painful. Now, most of the dividends are paid by the direct credit to your bank account. So, paying 3 times or 4 times in a year should not hurt good companies with adequate cash flow throughout the year. But if all your cash flow is happening in 1 month, which means, let's say you are a farmer and all your crops are coming in the month of November, you will get paid like that. But if you're a salary earner, you get monthly. If you are an interest earner, you could get quarterly or biannually, depending on what choice you make. So if you are an equity investor, you could either get fully back-ended or you could get interim throughout the year, which means a 10 rupees is sent to you as four checks of 2500. I mean, you will be compensated like that. It will get credited to your bank account. See, because the company has a consistent track record, you can even guess the yield at which you are currently investing. So if you bought a share at 100 rupees and the dividend payout is 7%, you will get 7 rupees. So that is the so when you talk of an equity, many people will come and talk to you about dividend yield and currently dividend yield, which is unbelievable. This is not a recommendation to buy Coal India, but Coal India looks like it is has a price which implies 11% dividend yield if the dividend remains the same. But please understand, 2020 has to be treated as something special. Don't assume companies will pay the same dividend. Companies may come with much worse results than you expect. Companies may not companies may even skip dividend. Remember, the regulator has told the companies that banks can't be issuing bank can't be paying out dividends this year, right? The other advantage is when a company pays a dividend, the market looks at it as a very good signal. I can't even imagine what will happen if HDFC Bank or HDFC Limited said we will not be paying dividends because we want to plow it back. Well, it makes no sense. For a startup, yes, it makes sense.